Aaron Berg is joining us. He is the host of In Hot Water, and you can see his documentary, 25 Sets, by going to Amazon or iTunes. 25 amazing record that this man set. He did 25 comedic sets in one night in New York City and was captured on film. Welcome back, Aaron Berg.
Thank you, David. Oh, the holidays are nigh. That's what they say. They are nigh. They're very close. It is time. I had sex with my wife this morning, unbeknownst to me. And she threw it on me, Dave, in the morning. Just fresh pussy omelet, we called it. She was tossing it at me. It was not vegan, if you know what I'm saying. I don't. But if you do, I don't. And guess what? One of us came. And that is a victory. What a special. She must have been so happy because I heard the president got a peach farm yesterday.
Yes.
Which will affect all of the markets. I wonder if the markets are going to drop today. But I had sex with my wife. It was there goes 46 days of trying not to out the window.
You woke up to her being in the mood.
Yes. She must have been having a dream about boning you and then woke up. And she, because I remember, she goes, give it to me, schmeckle face. And I said, why do you sound complaining when you're asking for it? She goes, come on, Feldo me up to the brim. That's what she said.
How often does she initiate?
That was the first time in about 3 years.
And were you in the mood? Did you need to go pee first?
No, I went pee first, then I came back. And unfortunately, what happens when I sleep, I guess a small dwarf comes to our house and shits in my mouth. Because whenever I wake up in the morning,
I know,
it smells like I've been munching on shit cakes. So what we did, instead of getting up to get mouthwash, I did what the priests call not doing anything, which is not kissing.
Yeah.
So I just kept my mouth shut and breathed out of my nose. And so she couldn't smell it.
Right.
And it was fun. She was the aggressor.
Right.
And we did intercourse until I completed. And then she said, maybe next time I can come. And then I ran out of the room angry and wept in the stairwell. It felt good. It felt nice.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever had sex. Have you had sex recently?
What sex is? What describe it to me. What is this thing
okay.
you speak of?
It's when two men care deeply about each other because they're upset with their fathers.
Uh-huh.
And these two men will meet, preferably in a hot space, a sauna, a steam room. They'll know it's time to start because you'll hear God yelling how angry he is. And then they penetrate one another, usually in the mouth first, then the chest plate. And then they weep. And they, as they finish, they sing three songs from Rent, the film. Usually in the order of La Vie Boheme, Rent, and No Day But Today. So that's what I heard.
Okay,
anyways.
So I have
know
had sex.
How I would
then.
Know.
I've had sex. I know what you're talking about, man.
It's pretty good. And then at the end, your penis spits in disgust.
Yes, yes. And then then it hides.
We don't need to talk about that. Why are we so talking about sex? I'll tell you why, David. Tonight, I'm doing a show at Stand Up New York called Consensual Sex. And I'm on it. And Jeremy Piven.
The actor, Jeremy Piven. Yes.
Isn't it amazing how years ago I used to watch him on HBO and now I'm a bigger deal.
He's opening for you, right?
He's featuring. I'm the headliner.
He's taking stand-up very seriously, isn't he? This is the Emmy Award-winning Ari Gold from Entourage. And he had that show, Mr. Something on Selfridge or something, Mr. Selfish.
Oh, I think that was after that. But he was a very good actor for several years,
actor from the Larry Sanders Show. He was like the head writer or one of the writers. He played one of the writers on the Larry Sanders show.
He had a very good acting career, and then some allegations, I guess, came out during a there was a wave, a movement. I think it was called Met OO, and it had something to do with either the New York Mets or something, but it was Met OO 0.0.
Yeah.
Met 0.0. And as such, now he is he's doing stand up. And as you mentioned, he's taking it very seriously, which is always a good thing in comedy, is to take it seriously. That's how you know it's going to be funny. You and I take it so seriously. I see you coming up with your theorems before you go on stage, uh-huh, and your formulas, E equals please laugh here. I see all that stuff happening. It's exciting. What an exciting day it's going to be.
So he took like
they asked me to take the flyer down. Somebody reached out. Someone put a flyer up, and his name's on it and my name's on it. So I shared it on social media, and then the club asked me to take it down because his people have a problem with him being mentioned with consensual sex. That is against brand for what he's doing.
Well, I guess he took a polygraph test to prove that he never groped anybody. An official polygraph, mm-hmm, test administered by a member of the American Polygraph Association. But
yeah,
he had a new
APA
series.
APA. They're an agency as well. The APA.
Yes.
I know them. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
And he had, right when the Me Too movement started, he was on Wisdom of the Crowd. And because of the allegations, Les Moonves, in November of 2017, canceled Jeremy Piven's series because of allegations of sexual misconduct or inappropriate behavior.
Well, this is awful.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, Moonves thinks you're inappropriate.
Right. Forget about him. What about Moore Moonves, his brother? His brother got everything handed, uh-huh, to him. Les had to work for everything he got. More Moonves got to go to the best schools, was a member of the equestrian team. Uh-huh. More Moonves punched his own ticket. Les Moonves had to work for everything. He always got less. Always the scraps, always the hand-me-downs, always the leftovers. Les Moonves had it rough. Remember when we had on the show... who was it? Nat King Cole's young son. That was
Beautiful Clean. Singer. Beautiful Clean.
Beautiful Clean Cole. Who was that too? Unforgettable. In every way. Could I get my spit bucket up here? And forevermore. It's happy. Oh, that is green. That cannot be. That's why, John. Incredible. Could somebody replace the bandage on my thorax? I'm in Beautiful Clean Cohen. Make sure you stop by the merchandise stand and pick up our soot hats. Oh, that's from the 80s. Oh, Lord.
What was it like growing up with Nat as your father, Beautiful Clean?
I'll tell you this. It was like being a canary in a mine, if you know what I'm saying.
Christmas have been the most precious time of the year, considering that he always associate.
I used to sing, my father would sit me down on his filthy lap and say, come here, BCC. He's short form for all the kids. I was Beautiful Clean. The other ones were Run Outa. And I recall him sitting me down. Excuse me. But I recall... He was a great father, and he would sit me down and say, it's beginning to feel a lot like Christmas. And it's the horrible part is we're Jewish. I don't know if you know our last name. Our last name is actually spelled K-O-H-L.
You're Ethiopian. Right, you're Ethiopian. That's correct. Falafels?
Yes, not the falafels. The galoshes is what they would call us at school, but it was something else. It's not falafels, but you're getting at it. We weren't Levi's or the other ones, GWGs. We were a different type of Jew. The falafels or something like that.
Yeah, were you accepted in Beverly Hills? I understand that when you guys moved in, it wasn't a welcome wagon for the Coles.
It wasn't. I remember fist fighting Lisa Presley one day. And she said to me, she goes, "Your father's a nobody." And I said, "How's this?" And I threw a peanut butter sandwich at her with marshmallows on it while I pretended to die shitting on the toilet. And I looked at her, and then I injected some B12 in between my toes and said, "Does this remind you of home, Lisa?" When I was four, I used to forge letters from my father and buy cigarettes.
Now, who was the better singer, you or your sister Natalie? You never did a duet with your father, posthumously, the way your sister Natalie did.
No, I was allergic to humidity. The problem was... I remember Natalie coming of age. She was 13. And around the house, she had just become a woman, if you will. Uh-huh. However, I was coughing up so much blood, nobody knew whose tissues were whose. So my father would yell at her and say, "Natalie, you've got to stop coughing and throwing it in the trash bin." And she goes, "Father, something's happening to me." And I said, "Father, something's happening to me."
Beautiful claim. Gee. So have you had a singing career? Do you tour at all?
I get booked still to do legions and fire halls. And it's great because I feel like I'm giving back, you know. There we go. I'm giving back to the servicemen of this country, which are the people that make this country great. Yeah. And I feel good about that. And a lot of people confuse me with being one of the first responders at 9/11 due to my breathing. And I say, "No, this is from where I am." But you know, you're either going to make $400 or you ain't. So that's how I look at it.
We're talking with Nat King Cole's oldest son, beautiful clean Cole. And I have to tell you, this time of year, do you miss your dad? It has to. You hear him on the radio all the time, right?
We when we light the menorah, starting this year, we'll be lighting the menorah. And then, blah! Blah! I believe on the 23rd will be the first day, and whenever we get to the fourth day, I always remember the oil lasted 8 days, but the coal would have lasted 14 days.
And it would have been beautiful and clean, just like you. Would you grace us with perhaps a Hanukkah song?
I would indeed. Bear with me while I clean the voice up.
This is going to be O Hanukkah, as performed by Nat King Cole's oldest son, beautiful clean Cole.
Please bear with me. me, 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 mole. The teeth, the tips, the tongue. The teeth, the tips, the tongue. These teeth are too white, and I am Thanos.
Luke. Let me ask you a question, beautiful Clayne.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Do you have allergies? Because you sound a little raspy.
It's just where I do it. Oh, Hanukkah. Hanukkah. I pray for you. Hanukkah. Your tree is bright. Your meat is fresh. The cheese will not go on my dish. Oh, Hanukkah. Oh, Hanukkah. 8 gifts of coal for your kids to private schools and smelly boobies to too much perfume and grabbing boobies. Oh, Hanukkah. Oh, Hanukkah. Dreidel, dreidel, dreidel. I made it out of purple clay. And when it's dry and ready, my phlegm I will play. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, beautiful Clayne. You know, I think talent doesn't skip a generation. I think you are the one with the gift.
You know you.
Did you
pick... You have a very honest opinion.
Did you sense jealousy from your father growing up?
My father? Very jealous man. I remember one time he caught me fucking my mother. And...
That would be his wife, correct?
At the time. And... Mary had a little. He walked in.
Uh-huh.
And he said, "Butte, what are you doing?"
Butte.
And I said,
"Butte."
Yes, Butte. And I said, "What you wouldn't." And I remember at that time he'd cut me off from any royalties or will.
So you had to make it on your own. It sounds like he was just looking for an excuse to cut you out of the will, out of jealousy.
Well, I will say this. If he would have put me in the will, I wouldn't be in Mineola this Friday at the old firehouse.
And if you want to see beautiful Clayne Cole, Nat King Cole's son, performing, go to Mineola at the old firehouse this Friday night. And what do you do? Do you talk to the crowd? What is a show featuring beautiful Clayne?
Fuck me with a goddamn hammer. I start out, I do a couple songs, a medley. Basically, whatever songs I lift, I do a lot of buble now. I was closing with My Heart Will Go On. And then I'll do a Q&A for roughly 2.5-3 hours. I'll take 5 questions. And it takes 2.5-3 hours to answer those 5 questions.
Now, is the firehouse in Mineola, is that an actual firehouse or is that a club?
Mm-hmm. That's actually a house that caught fire 3 years ago.
So you, as I understand it, you go into burning homes and entertain the firefighters while they're trying to put it out. Is that correct?
That's sure. And a lot of people will go, "Here's a mask." I'll go, don't need it.
You've carved out a special career for yourself. Beautiful Clayne.
Well, I'm like an Indian man that's seen and done everything. You know what they call him? Been there, done that. I like to put jokes in the act now, too. I'll do a lot of Chinese accents, and when people stare at me, I'll go, What? That's my Saturday Night Live audition thing. That's what I'll say.
Well, if you see a burning house in your neighborhood, run inside and catch Beautiful Clean Cole performing. What a show.
Thank you. It's really a big to do, and it's a waste not, want not. They'll say it's really we've gone next level. I use a projector, and I'll show small towns that thrive on coal, both of them, and I'll show those towns, and people get very excited about it. Right.
Now you quit smoking 5 years ago, right? Because I can tell.
But that's right, off and on. I haven't smoked in about 4 minutes now.
Are you on the patch? No. How do you have the discipline not to light up?
No, I am not native. Not native at all. I am not an Apache. But I will, from time to time, use bandages to put over my gaping throat wound.
Thank you, Beautiful Clean Cole. Catch him in Mineola Friday night at a house on fire. It'll be a house
really
on fire.
Really a pleasure. Really a pleasure. And you can also go to my website, needmucinex.com, and you can donate there.
Thank you, Beautiful Clean Cole. And hey, Aaron, we had Beautiful Clean Cole on today.
He's a get. I heard him on Jim and Sam a couple years ago, and he really knocks it out of the park. He's very well spoken.
Yeah.
Talented artist. Mm-hmm. Do you know he slept with his mother, and in doing so, that negated him from the will of his father?
He was just talking about that.
Yeah, it's one of the better known things. I heard about it on Breitbart, and then Alex Jones deconstructed it before getting kicked off of Vimeo.
Beautiful Clean Cole. I think that was the first thing you ever did on the show, right?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No, I was just on your show as myself.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yeah. Well, but he is, I didn't know he was Jewish, which is exciting because it's Hanukkah time. Are you excited? What do you have planned?
What do I have planned for Hanukkah? I pretty much nothing. I don't have young kids anymore. And, you know.
Oh, because the Epstein thing. What else?
Well, that's been.
So you're not going to do anything? Are you going to go out for Chinese food?
On Christmas Eve?
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to just. I think if Beautiful Clean Cole is setting fire to some homes in Mineola again, maybe I'll go see him perform.
Do you miss Hanukkah? Because you used to celebrate as a child.
You know what? I happen to have a clip. Believe it or not, I happen to have a clip of my very first Hanukkah.
Your first Hanukkah? You remember that?
Well, it was audio tape. We don't have.
Oh.
My dad used to carry a microphone with him at all times. Would you like to hear my first Hanukkah?
I would love to. Oh. That'd be great.
Okay. Play clip number three, please.
Billy, 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 the past. All right, everybody. I'm home from my work business in the schmata trade since I moved here. And I'm a very somewhat moderately successful Jewish man named David Feldman's father. Hello, wife. Now, as you know, we all get 8 gifts. And those gifts stand for each one of the reindeer that the Jews slaughtered when Santa tried to come to our house. And we rubbed the reindeer blood on the door so Santa knew not to fuck with any of us. Because Bugsy Siegel was a gangster, and so was Meyer Lansky. So, as you know, not all 8 gifts are going to be great. David, today you get a thumbtack. Open it. Now, David, what's going on? I went to preschool today, and I was very upset, angry, because I made pee-poo in my pants at the same time. And the other kids laughed at me, and they go, David made a latke. David made a latke. And I got upset, and I thought my pee was applesauce. Now, you don't let the children make fun of you because of latkes and applesauce, David. You are going to Beverly Hills Junior Kindergarten School, and you're going to grow up to be a somebody. Do you understand? Why do you always have to yell at them like that, Harold? You shut up, Myrna. You keep it down. Myrna. Now, go get the dreidel out of my gun rack. Go get it. David, put your thumbtack in your leg until it's time to play with it again. Ew, it hurts. That is to remind you of the pain that the Jews had when we went through the thumbtack desert, which happened in 1914. Now bring the dreidel over here. Bring it over, David. All right, Father, Dad. Also, do I get my gelts yet? You don't get your gelts until we play the Hanukkah game with the dreidel. Okay, now get the matzos and the celery and the salt water and shake your lulav. I'm a busy man. We have to put all the holidays into one this year. All right, good. The bread, throw it out. Get the vanta, horseradish, rub it in your eyes. The horseradish in your eyes. That is to know the pain that the Jews go through with optometry. All right, now that you've got the glasses on your eyes, spin the dreidel, David. Spin it. Spin it. On your nose. Vergutzen schnazen. Vergutzen schnazen. Good. Now I'll sing. Honey, put on the beautiful, clean, cold album on the Victrola. Dance, David. Dance like you're a dance like you're a. But Father, you're not allowed to say these things anymore. It's not anymore. It's 1961. You shut up and dance. You know, I saw Sammy Davis Jr. one time running away from a car with a television. I don't know if it was Dad. You can't say these things. I'm going to be very liberal in a few. Yeah. And the dreidel has landed on the Ahmed. I don't know if that's a letter, but you get no gelt. Give me my gold back. Go to your room and cry until you get hair around your schneck. Goodbye.
You are amazing, sir. You really are. Aaron,
it seems like you had a really tough time at Hanukkah, and it didn't seem like a joyous occasion.
No.
That's why you don't want to celebrate anymore.
No. Brings back memories. Really does.
I guess. It's really sad. Well, I feel for you.
Aaron Berg, you can watch him on In Hot Water. What is the name of your book?
Mr. Manners, Proper Etiquette for the Modern Degenerate and American Etiquette Failing Upwardly. Well, sorry, I just waxed my own testicles.
No, there's a note here that we have to bleep a certain word.
Oh.
26 minutes and 47 seconds.
We can't.
Yeah.
Contextually, it works. All right.
2809. We have to bleep that. Okay. let's start again. 25 sets on Amazon. Go see this documentary. Go buy it, stream it on Amazon. 25 sets starring Aaron Berg and the entire New York City comedy community. And In Hot Water is your podcast. The name of your...
And our Patreon show is called Gum Fridays, patreon.com/gumfridays. It's like In Hot Water, but much more acceptable.
And the name of your book?
Mr. Manners, Proper Etiquette for the Modern Degenerate and American Etiquette Failing Upwardly in a Fox News Nation.
Follow you on Twitter, Aaron Berg Comedy. Fantastic.
You got it.
Happy holidays, sir. You are
happy holidays.
You are so funny.
Too.
You are so funny. You're just
I love
incredible.
Talking to you.
You're incredible.
Brings me so much joy. Right. Have a great time.
Stand in line for one quick second, sir.